New developments overnight in Washington. Senate was up late. Vice President Pence cast the deciding vote to repeal a rule that makes it easier for consumers to sue banks or credit card companies. And this morning, the shockwave still being felt after two Republican senators blasted President Trump. Arizona Senator Jeff Flake will join us in a moment. He said yesterday, enough is enough.
He did call the president reckless in that speech, George. And Tennessee Senator Bob Corker, as you said, accused Trump of debasing the presidency. Our senior congressional correspondent, Mary Bruce, all the reaction coming in this morning on Capitol Hill. Good morning, Mary.
Good morning, Robin. Well, we are witnessing an astounding public indictment of the integrity of a sitting president from members of his own party. Senator Jeff Flake yesterday said he cannot be complicit to the president's behavior, which he called reckless, outrageous, and undignified. And this morning, he's urging his fellow Republicans to take a long, hard look at what they stand for.
This morning on Capitol Hill, a widening war within the Republican Party.
We must stop pretending that the degradation of our politics and the conduct of some in our executive branch are normal. They are not normal.
On Tuesday, Arizona Senator Jeff Flake announced he will not run for re-election, declaring he cannot work with a leader he finds dangerous to democracy.
I rise today to say enough.
Flake, a longtime critic of President Trump, said his decision was a matter of duty and conscience.
We have fooled ourselves for long enough that a pivot to governing is right around the corner. A return to civility and stability right behind it. We know better than that.
But this morning, some of the president's allies are celebrating Flake's departure. Sources close to Steve Bannon, who's declared war on Trump's opponents, say his reaction crushed him. Another day, another scalp.
Hey guys.
But Flake is not alone. Senator Bob Corker, another top Republican not seeking re-election, is also unloading on the president.
And I think the worst of it is going to be just the whole debasing, if you will, of our nation.
You think the president's debasing the nation?
I don't think there's any question.
It all comes as the president is trying to unite the party around tax reform.
Mr. President, any comment on Senator Corker?
But the infighting is overshadowing his agenda.
Does any of this make the president pause and wonder if he is doing anything wrong, that he bears any responsibility?
I think that they were not likely to be reelected, and I think that shows that the support is more behind this president than it is those two individuals.
But Republican leader Mitch McConnell says he regrets Flake's decision, praising him as a fine man who has brought high principles to the Senate. And McConnell's job up here may be getting more difficult. Senate Republicans have just a two-vote majority. And this morning, George, you have at least two top Republicans with little to lose and little incentive to fall in line behind the president.
I love you.